Hello, Namaste, myself, M.S. Basargaon, Assistant Professor, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Now, learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to solve homogeneous linear equation. Now, we'll see what is Cauchy's homogeneous linear equation. An equation of the form x raised to n, d raised to n y by dx raised to n plus k1 x raised to n minus 1 into d raised to n minus y by dx raised to n minus 1 plus so on plus k suffix n minus 1 into x dy by dx plus kn y equal to x, where k1, k2, k3 and so on kn are constants and x is function of x is called Cauchy homogeneous linear equation. Now, such equation can be reduced to linear differential equation with constant coefficients by using the substitution x equal to e raised to z, that is z is equal to log x. Then we can calculate the value of dy by dx, that is dy by dx is equal to dy by dz into dz by dx. Here dz by dx is 1 by x, which is equal to dy by dz into 1 by x. Multiplying throughout by x, we get that is x dy by dx is equal to dy, where here d stands for d by dz, and differentiating both sides dy by dx with respect to x, we get similarly x square d square y by dx square is equal to d into d minus 1 of y. Similarly, we get x cube d cube y by dx cube is equal to d into d minus 1 into d minus 2 of y and so on. After making this substitution in equation number 1, that is in Cauchy homogeneous equation, we get a linear differential equation with constant coefficient which can be solved by the method of linear differential equation with constant coefficients. Now, solve the following linear differential equation with constant coefficient d square y by dx square minus 5 dy by dx plus 6y equal to e raised to 3x. Pause the video for a while and find the solution of this equation. Now I hope you are solved. Here given equation is d square y by dx square minus 5 dy by dx plus 6y equal to e raised to 3x. And in symbolic form it can be written as d square minus 5d plus 6 of y equal to e raised to 3x. And here we have to calculate first CF, that is with the help of auxiliary equation. The auxiliary equation is here d square minus 5d plus 6 equal to 0. Now factors of this polynomial are d minus 2 into d minus 3, that is d minus 2 into d minus 3 equal to 0, that is d equal to 2 and d equal to 3. Now we can write the complementary function as CF is equal to C1 e raised to 2x plus C2 e raised to 3x. Now we can calculate PI. PI equal to 1 by d square minus 5d plus 6 of e raised to 3x, which is equal to x into 1 by 2d minus 5 of e raised to 3x, since we know 1 by f of d of e raised to ax is equal to x into 1 by f dash of d e raised to ax if f of a equal to 0. Here a is 3, if you put d equal to 3, here the denominator will become 0. Now which is equal to x into 1 by, now we can replace d by 3 here, that is 2 into 3 minus 5 e raised to 3x, which is equal to x into e raised to 3x. Therefore, the complete solution of the given linear differential equation is y equal to CF plus PI, that is y equal to here CF is C1 e raised to 2x plus C2 e raised to 3x and PI is plus x e raised to 3x. Now, we will solve the homogeneous differential equations. Solve x square d square y by dx square minus 2x dy by dx minus 4y is equal to x raised to 4. Now this is a homogeneous linear equation, and to express this homogeneous to linear, the standard substitutions are x equal to e raised to z, that is z is equal to log x, so that x dy by dx is equal to d of y, and x square d square y by dx square equal to d into d minus 1 of y, where here d stands for d by dz. Now substituting all these values in the given equation, we get d into d minus 1 minus 2d minus 4 of y equal to e raised to z raised to the power 4. That is, by simplifying this, we get d square minus 3d minus 4 of y equal to e raised to 4z. Let us call this as a equation number 1. Now, which is a linear differential equation with constant coefficients, and its auxiliary equation is d square minus 3d minus 4 equal to 0. That is, the factors of this polynomial are d plus 1 into d minus 4 equal to 0, that is d equal to minus 1 and 4. Here both the roots are real and different, therefore we can write cf as a equal to c1 e raised to minus z plus c2 e raised to 4z. Now we'll calculate the second part, that is pi equal to 1 by d square minus 3d minus 4 of e raised to 4z. Again, if you replace here d equal to 4 here in place of d square and d, we get 0. Therefore, here we can multiply by z, which is equal to z into 1 by derivative of d square is 2d, and derivative of minus 3d is minus 3, and derivative of minus 4 is 0 of e raised to 4z. Since 1 by f of d of e raised to ax is equal to x into 1 by f dash of d of e raised to ax if f of a equal to 0, which is equal to, now we can replace here d by 4, that is z into 1 by 2 into 4 minus 3 of e raised to 4z, which is equal to z by 8 minus 3, that is 5 of e raised to 4z. Hence, the solution of equation number 1 is y equal to cf plus pi, that is equal to c1 e raised to minus z plus c2 e raised to 4z plus pi is z by 5 e raised to 4z. Putting z is equal to log x, that is e raised to z equal to x, we get y equal to c1 x raised to minus 1 plus c2 x raised to 4 plus log x by 5 x raised to 4, which is the solution of the given equation. Now we'll solve one more example. Solve x square d square y by dx square plus 2x dy by dx minus 12y is equal to x cube log x. Now we can make use of the substitution x equal to e raised to z, that is z is equal to log x, so that x dy by dx equal to d of y, x square d square y by dx square equal to d into d minus 1 of y, where d stands for d by dz. Now substituting these values in the given equation, we get d into d minus 1 plus 2d minus 12 of y is equal to e raised to 3z into z. By simplifying this, we get d square plus d minus 12 of y equal to e raised to 3z into z. Let us call this as a equation number 1, and which is the linear differential equation with constant coefficients. Now its auxiliary equation is d square plus d minus 12 is equal to 0. That is, factors of this polynomial are d plus 4 into d minus 3 equal to 0. That is, the d equal to minus 4 and 3. Therefore, complementary function for these values, we get cf is equal to c1 e raised to minus 4z plus c2 e raised to 3z. Therefore, now we can calculate pi. Pi is equal to 1 by f of d, that is here f of d is d square plus d minus 12 of e raised to 3z into z, which is equal to, we can write e raised to 3z, and we can replace d by d plus 3, that is d plus 3 whole square plus d plus 3 minus 12 of z, since we know 1 by f of d of e raised to ax into v is equal to e raised to ax into 1 by f of d plus a of v, which is equal to e raised to 3z, 1 by d square plus 6d plus 9 plus d plus 3 minus 12 of z, that is equal to e raised to 3z into 1 by d square plus 7d plus z. Now, by simplifying it, pi equal to e raised to 3z 1 by 7d. Now, shifting this to the numerator, we can write 1 plus d by 7 raised to minus 1 of z, which is equal to e raised to 3z by 7d. Now, expounding this by using binomial expansion, we get 1 minus d by 7 plus d by 7 whole square minus so on of z. Since we know the binomial expansion, 1 plus x raised to minus 1 is 1 minus x plus x square minus x cube and so on, which is equal to e raised to 3z by 7d. Now, operating this bracket on z, 1 into z, that is z, minus 1 by 7 into d of d means derivative of z is 1, that is 1 by 7, which is equal to e raised to 3z by 7 into bracket, what you get, z minus 1 by 7 dz, which is equal to e raised to 3z by 7. Now, integration of this z minus 1 by 7 is z square by 2 minus 1 by 7 z. Thus, the solution of equation number 1 is y equal to c1 e raised to minus 4z plus c2 e raised to 3z plus pi, that is e raised to 3z by 7 into bracket z square by 2 minus 1 by 7 z. Now, putting z is equal to log x and e raised to z equal to x, we get y equal to c1 x raised to minus 4 plus c2 x cube plus x cube by 7 into bracket log x whole square by 2 minus 1 by 7 x, which is the solution of the given equation.